Hello. In this video, we are going to learn how to fix intersections on meshes. As you can see on my screen, we have a few different meshes to work on. We have our neutral expression, our eyes model, upper teeth mesh, and a set of fax expressions. Let's start our process by working on the teeth mesh. This model is a result of wrapping the teeth template onto a scan. That's why it has some intersections between the teeth. To fix them, let me add a new node called Fix Intersections. All we need to do is plug our mesh with an intersection into the first input. As a result, it fixes all the intersections automatically. It smoothly fixes our geometry so that the teeth don't intersect. Now let's see how it works on a facial expression. If we zoom in on the lips, you can see an intersection. And once again, all we need to do is to add the Fix Intersections node and plug our fax into the first input. Right now, this node works on a whole mesh. But if you're using a mesh that has a high number of polygons, it will work, albeit slowly. There's a solution to this. Let's create a vertex mask node to select what parts of the mesh will be affected by the Fix Intersections node. Let me rename it to Lips Mask. Let's set the intensity to 100. Let's also change the symmetry to topological and enable the Use Geodesic Distance option. In this case, I will select those parts of the mesh that represent the lips. This vertex mask will make the Fix Intersections node work faster, because now it will work only on the vertices we've selected. Let's switch to another frame. For example, this one. Here you can see a large intersection. But after applying the node, it fixes that. Note that if we increase the resolution distance parameter, the distance between the upper and lower lip gets larger. Also, decreasing the smoothness weight parameter will make our lips deform less and look softer. If we increase it, that will affect a much bigger area of the mesh. I will change it back to the default value. Let me turn off the wireframe. At first glance, you might think that this node doesn't change the general look of the mesh. But if we turn it on, you can see how it affects our shading and mesh. The last example I want to showcase is the intersection between our eyeball geometry and our neutral mesh. Let me create another Fix Intersection node. In this case, we want to deform our face geometry to fit the eyeballs in. To do that, let me plug the neutral mesh into the first input and the transformed eyeball geometry into the third input. I will add a mixed geom node to see the result more clearly. As you can see, the node result is pretty good, but I don't like how it deforms the outer eyelid of our mesh. To fix that, let me decrease the smoothness weight to 2. That will make the deformation affect a smaller part of the mesh. So, that's it for this tutorial. See you in the next video.